All right, so now we came to analysis of commingling of merchandise. What is commingling of merchandise? It's where you take a bunch of stuff and you mix it up. So we have take a bunch of stuff, kind of put them together like this, throw them all in one container without counting them, and bring them into the country. Fred is importing used screws and nails from Germany. So you have screws and nails, two items, and they're kind of mixed up, right? See, read the question. What is the rate of duty that would be applied to commingled goods? So already you know, you have commingled goods. It's a statement. All right. So you have screws, you have nails. You even have a country of origin, right? And the idea is to smelt the used nails and screws and mold them into the brackets. Okay, so he plans to make further work, but he kind of have bunch of screws, bunch of nails. He has no idea how many, but he knows just they're all part of the big mix, right? So they're mixed. And what is the rate of duty? Well, we know the general rule of thumb is highest rate of duty applicable. What's the highest rate? Well, we have customs examiners give us two rates, 6.2% and 3%. Which one do you, what's the highest? 6.2%. So 6.2% is the right answer choice. 8206000. Look at the heading terms. Tools. Remember we talked about saw circle or saw blades, right? As being tools in there in 8203, I believe. So 8206 says tools of two or more headings that are put up in sets for retail sale. So you have commingled merchandise. It must be in sets for retail sale. But let's take a look at the other one. Sets of articles, not necessarily for retail sale, of two or more in foregoing subcategory. What's foregoing? Foregoing means the one that were above, right? The one that were previously mentioned. Subheadings. So you have this one line item that describes many articles. And those many articles can be put together. So if those articles are described in one subheading, you can put them together and enter them under this HTS US number. Say, in a commingled mix, the blue pen is subject to quota, everything else is not. Can we get some kind of special treatment for the quota? Well, because it's restricted merchandise, and if customs, if they have noticed that this quota merchandise is there, they are legally required to restrict the merchandise. I mean, there are exceptions such as small amounts, right? Personal use, I think under $200, like minuscule quantities. But we're talking about commercial shipments. Containers, right? So customs will say, look, we cannot give you, they are legally not allowed to give entry for this one, right? So most likely what you will end up having is you have to segregate. So customs will give you a notice to segregate and an opportunity to segregate. In opportunity to segregate, they will say you must take this out of the equation. And then they will discuss this in the future. So.